from verse 28. Joel chapter 2, verse number 28. The book of Joel chapter number 2 from verse number 28. I believe God that before the end of this service, somebody will go home with a smile. If I hear your amen, heaven will respond to you. I want to thank my father, Reverend Joshua Talina, and my mama, Mama Jackie. Let's clap our hands for Jesus. I want to thank them for this opportunity to be a blessing to your life. Are you there? Let's see. And it says, and it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream, and your young men shall see vision. And also upon the servant and upon the handmaid in those days will I pour out my spirit. And I will show my wonders in the heaven and in the earth. Blood and fire and pillars of smoke. Take your seat. Open your hand, let me pray for you. Anything that God wants to do in your generation, may you be among those that God will use to accomplish it. I say, whatever that God wants to do in your generation, may you be among those that heaven will use to accomplish that task. In your family, anything that God wants to do in your family, may you be among those that God will begin with, as you shout a louder amen. I prophesy that you will have a manifestation from today's encounter. I said you have a manifestation from today's encounter. Let me hear that your amen come like a thunder. Every good thing begins from one day. Every great thing starts from one day. Every greatness starts with one day. Every testimony proceeds from one day. Every breakthrough starts from one day. Anything that God wants to do begins from a day. Am I talking to anybody here? Anything you will do, if you will be great, it starts from a particular day. It is a day that begins your going to school. It is a day that marks your graduation. It is a day that marks your getting a job. It is a day that marks your promotion. It is a day that marks when you get married. Women, don't play with dates. You can joke with any other thing for a woman, but don't joke with what? You see, date. Women don't joke with it. You can forget your own birthday, but don't forget your wife's birthday. Women don't joke with wedding day and anniversary day. Wedding anniversary and their birthday. Don't joke with it. They will be the one to remind you. And if you fail to be reminded, they will remind you by force. But you can forget your own, no? You don't have issue, forget your own. No problem. But you see that their own, it is mandatory and compulsory. No matter where you find yourself, they must call you to remind you. That's to tell you that the power of a particular date. There is a day that people don't forget in their life. It is called a day of encounter. There are 2 days in a man's life that a man cannot forget. One is the day of encounter. Two is the day of experience. The day of encounter is the day that something remarkable happens to the man. And the day of experience is the day the man learns something remarkable. A day of encounter is the day that something remarkable happens to a man. And the day of experience is the day that a man learns something that is remarkable. Those are the 2 days in a man's life that a man can never forget. These 2 days precedes a man's life, precedes what happens in a man's life, precedes how his future will be, precedes the kind of joy he will have. You can either have a good encounter or a bad encounter, but these 2 days precedes how joyful your life will be, precedes how sorrowful your life will be. A man can learn something bad in a day. A man can learn something good in a day. Under a day, a man can say, child, life is a teacher. Under a day, a man can say, had I known. Under a day, a man can say, thank God for this particular day. Am I talking to somebody here? Under a day, a man can say, I caused this particular date. I remember when I went for crusade in Owerri, my elder brother came to see me in the hotel where I was lodging. As he entered the hotel, he said, "Chai, now here you lodge." I said, "Yes." He said, "I cursed the first day I entered this hotel." I said, "Why?" He said, "Ah, I never tell you." I said, "No." He said, "Ah, what did they do me for this hotel? What did they do me for this hotel? I just the pass. I see free breakfast in the morning when he was in Imsu. About 8 years ago, he was passing the hotel. He saw on the gate, breakfast buffet, free in the morning. The young guy entered into the buffet. You know buffet, ate. He chose everything because it was free. You know students now, and even went with his best friend. They selected rice, selected chicken, selected pizza, selected burger, selected spaghetti, selected macaroni, ate the first. Since it's free now, kill yourself. Ate, finish eating. As he wanted to go, the hotel people said, "Sir, you have to pay." He said, "No, it is free." They said, "No, sir, it is free for those who are lodging here." He said, "Bros," I said, "How did you come out?" He said, "That's the story." I said, "Tell me." He said, "I had to mop and wash all the dishes in the toilet." So I said, "Hey, something remarkable happens to a man." He said, "Hey, something bad happens to a man." He said, "So encounters precedes the joy in a man's life. Experiences precedes the happiness in a man's life." I prophesy to you in the name that is above other names. I prophesy testimony will enter your life. After my brother stayed with me that night in the hotel, the next morning, I said, "Let's go and eat buffet." He said, "No, you go." I said, "No, I'm lodging here." He said, "Brother, are you sure this room is not for only one person?" I said, "Even if it's for three persons, I will pay." He said, "My brother, that's my experience." He said, "Do you know I cleaned this hotel for 1 week? I was cleaning the hotel, I was washing dishes, and they left my friend to go. Because my friend said, I don't know, now he carry me come home. So both the one my friend ate and the one I ate." So it's an encounter. There are days in a man's life he will never forget. My prayer for you is that in this particular service today, what God will do for you in your marriage, what God will do for you in your finance, what God will do for you in your family, what God will do for you around you, as I hear your amen, it will be unforgettable. I said it shall be unforgettable. I said it shall be unforgettable. It shall be unforgettable. Let your amen be louder than your neighbor's amen. The Bible said, "And that day shall come, I will pour out my spirit." So it is not just every day. There is a particular day that encounter takes place. He said, "That day shall come, and I will pour out my spirit." Am I talking to anybody here? He said, "That particular day, it will be on a Monday like this, during breakfast hour, during lunch hour." He said, "I will pour my spirit." He said, "Your sons and daughters shall begin to prophesy." Am I talking to anybody here? He said, "Your men shall begin to see vision." So there is a particular day when God's visitation becomes massive and mighty in the life of a man. There is a day when God's hand will rest mightily on the hand of somebody. This day is a day that God turns your spark into a fire. This is the day that God turns the spark in your life into a fire. This is the day that God turns your test into a testimony. This is the day that God rewrites your story into a glory. I prophesy to you, lift up your hands in the name that is above other names. I declare to you today, you shall have an encounter in this service. You shall have an encounter in this service. Shout the amen like a thunder. Sit down. I've been preaching this gospel for a while. One of the worst moments you can get in the church is someone that goes to church the same way and leave the same way. Nothing pains more than that. Nothing hurts more than that. Going to church the way you are and then going the same way you are. How you enter church does not matter. How you enter the compound does not matter. Am I talking to anybody here? But it is how you live that determines how the service was. You can enter as a sinner. I told somebody, somebody said, "Ah, that your ministry. Now lay small children food there. Now lay sinners food there." I say, "Yes, I like it like that. Let the church be full of sinners. Let it begin with prostitutes. Let it begin with lesbians. But give them 1 year. When you come back, you will see those prostitutes to become preachers of the gospel. Am I talking to somebody here? I say yes. Let me have smokers in the church. Let me have womanizers in the church. Yes, let me have drunkards. Call me pastor. That pastor, drunk people, I will accept. But if you come there after 1 year and you do not see a change, then know that God did not call me. Because the gospel has the capacity to turn a sinner to a saint. Am I talking to anybody here? The gospel has the capacity to turn a nobody to a somebody, to transform a little person to a giant, to transform a chicken to an eagle, to transform a stone to a gold. I prophesy to you, by this encounter today, your life will turn around. I say your life will turn around. I say your life will turn around. Shout the amen, let it come like a thunder. Are you hearing me, somebody? The worst moment I can get, you can have, is somebody coming to church and going the same way they came. It is very painful. It's very hot. It's very bad that somebody entered the church and the same way he came, no transformation, no touch, no nothing left the man, nothing entered the man, nothing changed in the man's life, and the man still carried Bible the same way and went home. It is a painful thing. God said, and that day shall come. He said, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. He said, that shall be an encounter. Something will shift in the person's life. That will be a restoration. There will be something that I will do that will make you know that, yes, you enter shepherd house. There is something I will do that will make you say, thank God I attended this service. Am I talking to anybody here? There is something that will make you, each time you remember it, you will say, thank God I was in church that day. Am I talking to somebody here? That is a day of encounter. That is a day of manifestation. That is a day of testimony. Lift up your right hand. Say, Lord! Say, Lord! Shout it away. Say, Lord! Shout it again. Say, Lord! Say, Lord! Say, Lord! Release your encounter. 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 In Jesus' name we pray. Each time the Spirit of God comes upon you, what do you have? Number one is a changed life. Number one is a changed life. The Holy Spirit, when he enters you, we must know that something has changed around you. Yesterday, Mama was preaching something of this nature. That you cannot say you have encountered God and you still have unforgiveness. You still have malice in you. Am I talking to somebody here? There are things people do to me. They think I will get angry, but it will not get me angry. But that one you think is nothing, is the one that I may take very serious with you. The Holy Spirit, when you get this encounter, your life will change. There is no way you will be coming to church and we cannot differentiate you from those in the world. Every day you carry Bible, you come to church, you lift your hands. Sometimes you cry in the church. Sometimes you shed tears. But when we see you outside, there is no change life. There is no change character. There is no change personality. There is nothing to show that you have encountered God. It is an error. It is highly erroneous that the same way you are every year, you hear these messages we preach. You hear this, we lay hands on you. We declare upon your head. And yet there is nothing to show. Am I talking to anybody here? No man encounters God and remain the same. No man encounters God. No man ever meets God and remain the same. No man encounters God and remains the way he is. Each time you encounter God, God has a way of redefining you. God have a way of remolding you. God have a way of reshaping you. God have a way of remodeling you. No matter your past, no matter your ugly past, no matter your worst past, no matter your bad experiences, no matter the things they have told you, the moment you encounter God, something changes around you. Lift up your hands. I prophesy to you. You have been coming to church, but there is nothing to show. After this service today, you will have something to show. There will be a manifestation. There will be a miracle. Shout the amen like a thunder. A changed life. Saul of Tarsus, who always persecuted people, was on his way to Damascus to persecute God's children. When he encountered God, his life changed. He dropped knife, he dropped weapons, and he took the Bible. And he wrote almost 70% of what we have in the New Testament. Ladies and gentlemen, each time God changed your life, you become a historic person. Your life becomes a historic event. Your life becomes a Bible that people will read on their own. Am I talking to anybody here? No man encounter God and remain the same. After Jacob encountered God, God changed him from normal Jacob, from ordinary Jacob, from mere Jacob to an Israel. He became from a nobody to a somebody. From a nobody. He was running all the days of his life. Jacob was a fugitive. He ran. He cheated somebody. Somebody cheated him on top. He cheated his brother. He now went to marry. They cheated him times two. He ran from running to Laban to running for his life to running for this. But the day God encountered Jacob, he changed his name from Jacob to Israel, and his life turned around. Am I talking to somebody here? Jacob was carrying a prophecy, but the switch was not on because the prophecy was not activated yet. So you can carry prophecy, but without an encounter, there will not be an activation. Prophecy without encounter, it is encounter that makes your prophecy to be activated. Jacob was carrying prophecy of a great nation. They said, Jacob, you will be bigger than your brother. You will be this, you will be that. But all along, he was a fugitive. He was merely a servant. Was he actually the leader? How can you have a prophecy of rest and you're running upside down? Restlessness is because you have not met God in a place of encounter. When the Spirit is poured upon you, it will give expression to your destiny. The moment the Holy Spirit is poured upon your head, it will give expression. It will give introduction. It will give you a manifestation. Lift up your hands. I declare to you now, in the name of Jesus, after this service, you have an encounter. When this Spirit, Jesus went to Jordan to be baptized, the heavens opened. Something rested on him, and a voice came and said, "This is my beloved son with whom I am well pleased." That was when his ministry actually gained ground on earth. That was when his ministry actually gained relevance on earth. That was when his ministry actually had expression on earth. It was that singular encounter with the Spirit that made his life to begin to turn around. My dear, go for an encounter. Number two, anytime you have an encounter with God, you have a changed situation. You have a changed situation. When you have an encounter with God, you have a changed situation. You have a changed situation. You have a changed situation. Don't throw it away. Give it to God. He will turn it around. Don't throw it away. Don't conclude on anybody. Hand the person over to God, and you will see that even fibroid can turn to fine boy. That, am I talking to anybody here? That even sicknesses can shrink, all in the name of Jesus. A changed situation. Anytime you encounter this God, anytime the Holy Ghost comes upon you, your situation changes, your positioning changes. Where you are staying becomes a different environment. I prophesy to you now, in the name that is above other names, your situation will change after this service. Number three. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you have knowledge and revelation. You have knowledge and revelation. You have knowledge and revelation. Anytime you stop seeking for knowledge, you start dying. Anyone that does not have the Spirit of God remains stagnant. Bible says in the beginning, the Spirit of God came and was moving. Our God is not a God of stagnancy. When you encounter God, something must move around your life. The depth of your knowledge will increase. The depth of your knowledge will rise automatically. Let's celebrate our mama. Let's clap our hands for Jesus. Papa said, "What you know is what you show." Papa said, "What you know is what you show." When you despise insight, you lack foresight. What you know is what you show. When you despise insight, you lack foresight. No matter who you are, sir, anytime you feel you don't have anything to learn, you have started dying. No matter who you are, anytime you feel there is no money to acquire knowledge, know that you are beginning to go down. Sir, There are four kinds of revelation. Number one is revelation of God. God reveals himself to you the moment the Holy Spirit enters you. The Holy Spirit is another version of God. Just like water. Water has solid. Water has... water is solid. Water is a gaseous form. And water is a vapor. Am I correct? Water can be form of vapor. Water can be in form of solid. Water can be in form of liquid. God bless you. So these are the three categories of water. That is how God is. That is the same way the Holy Spirit is. It is another form of God. So the moment knowledge enters you, sir, the revelation of God, the Holy Spirit gives you the revelation of God. The Holy Ghost reveals God himself to you because he is God himself in another form. Mama made the explanation yesterday. In another form. So anytime you have knowledge about the Holy Ghost, you have had knowledge of God. No pastor can come and sway you off your feet when you are rooted in the things of God. Your knowledge of God will make you know when you see empty barrels and empty vessels, you will know. You see pastors who don't have anything, who God did not call. They are the ones that call themselves. You will know. And when you see the ones that are actually genuine, but they lack direction, you will know. A pastor can be genuine and still be making mistake. Don't look at me like that. A pastor can be genuine and be making mistake. Why? Because he may not have a mentor, a father, a guide, or a teacher. Because any anointing that you don't culture well will become vulnerable. Church is quiet. Do you understand what I just said now? That's why you have young pastors who are sometimes filled with Holy Ghost at a time that God was raising them. Pride entered. Pride, insincerity, the love of money, they lose control. They begin to address the oldest person as if he is their younger brother. Am I talking here? The first 5 million hit the account. I used to tell Papa, how you check who is loyal is somebody that has seen money and is still humble to you. It's not by who is hungry. Come and be saying, my father, my papa, my daddy. No, now hunger, they wire the person. When somebody have seen money, you know this person is not begging. But the person still decide to bring his head down so that this one will go far. Am I talking here? A lot of pastors can camouflage now. A lot of them, when they need something from you, once their eyes is on that thing they need, they will use their tongue and lick your shoe. Give it to them. You will talk from my father to my brother. People like us, who money don't move. There's no money I've not seen. I'm an Igbo man. We like money. But money cannot change my personality. There is nothing God says I should give I cannot give now as you see me. Revelation of God. Ignorance is the breeding ground of Satan to attack a believer. Number two is the revelation of your personality. Anytime the Holy Ghost enters you, sir, you begin to understand yourself the better. You look at yourself and said, I am not what people say I am. I am who God says I am. Many of you have left your verdict in the hand of your enemies. You have accepted what people say about you and not what God is saying about you. How can you reduce yourself to the level where people place you? Do you know who you are? Somebody look at you finish and said, this one, liver, nothing good can come out. I like that kind of challenge. When people look at me and say, we shall see where he will end. I like that kind of challenge. I used to tell somebody, if you're waiting for me to fall, I'm waiting for you to die. I will first come for your burial. Revelation of your personality. Don't let people's perspective define your personality. When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, sir, yourself will become more clearer to you. They may not like your face, but they will like your future.
Don't let anybody use your past
to judge your present. Simply because you know my yesterday, doesn't mean you hold my tomorrow.
When you know the Holy Ghost in you,
your personality, you will have confidence in your gifting. People will not do guy for you again.
You will know that once God is with you, sir,
he must make an alternative for you. That must be, he must send backup for you. I don't know why I'm talking to here. Yourself, he will reveal. Holy Ghost makes you to have a knowledge about who you really are. Many of you in the church here, you are underusing your ability. You have giftings to be in the greeters department. All this catwalking, you are catwalking from Gwarimpa to Asokoro. My friend, come here and be useful to us. Enter the greeters department. Stand like this with welcome to church. Stand like this with welcome to church. Be useful. All these things you used to talk, gossip, gossip, gossip. If you see the way you talk. My friend, join evangelism. Don't waste that your saliva. Use it to convert soul. All this one, that small thing you have removed shirt in the street, you want to fight. My friend, join protocol. Join protocol. Become Brother Wilson. What do you quack the person?
The Holy Ghost gives you clearer revelation
of your what? Personality. Suppose I know who God says I am. Say to a side, say, I know who God says I am. Say, I know who God says I am. Your personality. Lift your hands. I prophesy in the name that is above other names. May yourself become more clearer to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shout that amen. Let it come like a thunder.
Amen.
There is what occultic men do. It's called self-consciousness. Are you hearing me, somebody now? Occultic men. There are occultic men. They don't believe in God. But if they make a promise to you, they must keep it. It's like a principle. If they say, I will give you 10,000 tomorrow by 8 a.m. 7:59, they have called you on phone.
So if occultic men can realize themselves, if cultists can have identity,
that when they see their member, they will identify their member. Church is quiet. I don't even know what I'm talking about here. If an normal occult boy now, just caught all this secondary school or university caught, when they see their member, that is a how they will use to just either by color or by wearing or by handshake or by footstep, that will be something they will use to identify them. How much more you?
If you know what God has given to you, sir, you will not be angry when we don't prophesy to you. You will know that you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you. You will not be angry when you call our number 12 midnight, it is switched off. You will look at the devil and said, I know what I carry. I command you to go. Number 3 is revelation of covenant privileges and rights. Revelation of your covenant privileges and rights. Anytime the Holy Ghost enters you, sir, you begin to disseminate duties. Holy Ghost, each time these people, if you watch the scripture, Mama read yesterday, he said, as the Holy Ghost came upon them, they started living a life that will bring result to the kingdom. You cannot have the Holy Ghost and you are not useful to yourself, you are not useful to the church, you are not useful to your family, you are not useful to your generation, you are not even useful to your ancestors. There must be relevance attached to you. How can I be a son of Talina and there is nothing I am doing for his vision to go far?
I rather stay in Port Harcourt. How will I be his son and I'm not proud to be his son? Why will I be his son and I'll not support his vision? Whether he tell me come or not, I'll just buy flight ticket, come, lodge myself, worship service, go.
Whether I will minister or not, I will just, well, sometimes I come here. You don't know why I come. When my head is so full, I will just come sit down. And it's as if I will know, it's as if this, he's preaching that day. It's as if he has seen me in his dream a night before that day. So whatever he will preach, it's just me that is. At the time I was ministering at Sheikh, if you know the Sheikh I'm talking about, I stood my ground and told one guy, you will not have your way here. I will not tell you the long story. I stood my ground and said, if church want to close, let it close. You see this thing you want to do, I will not allow it. The guy said, okay. He left the church, started fighting me. In fact, fight is recruit. He will go to choir, recruit 15. Go to protocol, recruit 29. Go to greeters, recruit 10. You don't understand. They will be in the streets during church service. As you are coming to church, they will tell you, if they go to that church, like 20 people from the church are in the streets, booing people coming to church. Battle, no be small battle. I nearly die, you. Because it was my first time to experience that kind of thing as my own ministry. I nearly die. You are watching all your labor, all your efforts. They will go to internet, cook all kinds of things that I sent assassins to kill them, that I sent kidnappers to kidnap them. Right, put it online, tag people, sponsor. I just took flight ticket, came to Abuja that day. I didn't tell Papa I was coming to Abuja, I just lodged. The next day, Tazi carried me, I came, I sat down in front. Gospel is in church. I said, yes, sir. He said, we'll do the service together. I said, I know, come for service. Preach first. Papa began to preach. As he was preaching, he was addressing me. As he was preaching, he was addressing me. As he was preaching, he was addressing me. After he talked, my head full. So then when he comes, say, come carry myself. I didn't know what to say again. I just carried myself. Okay. Until I went back, I stood my ground. I fought the fight and regained my victory. I said, yes, this is how it should be. You should know your personality. Realize yourself. That's when you have your self-confidence. Not this one, you are busy blaming your pastor, blaming your this. Your pastor is not in church and you too will not come to church. My friend, you have made your pastor your God. Your pastor is not in church. And then you too say you're not being in church. Or your pastor is not in church. He now sends somebody to come. And the person is sent to you. You are looking at him with your eyeglass. You are indirectly saying that your spiritual father too. You are looking at him with what? Eyeglass. Because if he send anybody to you, remove what you know. You don't understand. Lift up your hands. That woman coming, I need to pray for you. Come, run to me. You are just coming to church? Run to me. Akama hutu onye dikagi. Ezekiloro ye biari lobo. Ezekiloro ye biari lobo. You are the Shekinah glory. You reign forever. You are the Shekinah glory. You reign forever. You are bigger than what people say.
Yes, sir.
You are bigger than what people say. 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 I say you are bigger than what people say. You are bigger than
what people say.
I say you are bigger than what people say. Say
you are bigger than what people say.
Abawa bawe. You are divine.
mighty man in battle. Say, hey, Shaddai, you are the mighty man in battle. In battle. Say, you are the
mighty man in battle. Glory to your name.
What manner of man is Jesus? Hallelujah. 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 What manner of man? Hallelujah. 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 Jesus, how wonderful you are. You are brighter than the morning star. The morning star say, you are. Yeah. Yeah. And the lily star grow. By the way,
you are precious. Oh, precious.
Yeah. receive. Hallelujah. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Spirit of the Lord, thank God I'm born again. Say, born of the Lord with the Spirit of the Lord, thank God I'm born again. Goodbye world, I'll stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, say, I stay no longer with you. Say, cause I'm dead on the path to go God's way for the rest of my life. Say, go God's way the rest of my life. Say, I'm burned up my mind to go God's way for the rest of my life. Oh, I'm burned up my mind to go
God's way for the rest of my life.
My tomorrow shall be greater than today. My tomorrow shall be greater than today. My tomorrow shall be greater. My tomorrow shall be greater. My tomorrow shall be greater than today. Somebody say,
my tomorrow shall be greater than today.
My tomorrow.
My tomorrow shall be greater than today.
My tomorrow shall be greater. My tomorrow shall be greater. Not today. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice.
Through God, through the Father,
through Jesus, the
Son,
say, and give him the glory.
Say,
when we walk with the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory he shapes on. On our way, way. While we do his good will, say, he abides with us this day. Somebody say, thank you.
Open your hand. As you were just coming to church, your fire opened. She never sit down. She was just coming with her handbag. And as I was preaching, God said, look at that woman coming to church. Look towards the backside. And I looked, and I see a pregnant woman. And the Lord said, tell her that after now, her tears will be over. Amen. Anyone that say amen today, your tears is over. Amen. If I hear your amen, heaven respond to your prayer request. Shout the first amen. Shout the second amen. Shout the third amen. Woman, wipe your tears. This is your last night in Egypt. The Lord opened my eyes and I saw that as you were coming to church, something was bothering you. Are you hearing me, ma? Something was bothering you. This is your pregnancy. Somebody is doing an attack on someone they call Kemi. What is your name?
Kemi.
Huh? Kemi. I saw an attack on someone they call Kemi. And the Lord said, they said you will deliver your baby through oppression. I'm seeing a report in your bag. A doctor's report. in your back. Your baby is not positioned where his head is facing down. Your baby is sitting down in the stomach, crossing his leg and staying like this. Lift your hands. I will soon summarize. Lift your hand. Who is ready to be blessed today?
Yes.
The person that jumped up and said, I change your condition.
Amen.
I restore the glory of your family background.
Amen.
I restore the glory of your father's house.
Amen.
If I hear your enemy, the God of my father will answer your prayers. He will answer your prayer.
Amen.
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 He will answer your prayer. Shout the amen 3 times. Number one.
Amen.
Number two.
Amen.
Number three.
Amen.
Open your hand wherever you are. There is an angel that will give you a gift from this altar. Open your hand. Kabarandos kepande. This new week you have entered in the month of March. I declare whatever you need that will make you to stand here and testify between now and Wednesday. In the name that is above other names, that call you want, that prayer you want God to answer, that gift you need, that visa you desire, that prayer request in your mouth, I prophesy to anyone who is shouting louder, amen. Your prayer shall be answered. 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 Shout the first amen. Shout the second amen. Shout the third amen. I declare to you now, in the name that is above other names, receive your manifestation. Receive your manifestation. Receive your manifestation. Shout amen loud and clear.
Amen.
I hear the Lord said to me in Isaiah 7:7. He said, it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. Where is the report? Huh? Please go and bring your bag. Come and make it happen. Just the keyboard, the strings only. They say, come and make it happen. Come and make it happen in my life today. They say, kwo no zuo. They say, kikwo no zuo. They say, kikwo no zuo. Kebili miri wederedu. Ebili miri wederedu. Ebili miri wederedu. Ebili amoyinwage deredu. Ebili miri wederedu. Iye pupedikuwe. Omborangu dike. Acho wachoti yanacho. Akaba hutu onye dikage. Eze niye pupedikuwe. Umbarangu dike. Acho wachoti yanacha. Akaba hutu onye dikage. Eze niye pupedikuwe. Eze niye pupedikuwe. Umbarangu dike. Acho wachoti yanacha. Akaba hutu onye dikage. Onye de meba biya. Woman, lie down here. Onye de meba biya. Anye na singi biya. Ezibo manso biya. Ezibo manso biya. Biya o biya. She na can keep me. Adilonya dikake. Omalite no gugu. Adiri onye dikake. Olori 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 olori.
Shinaka Kigwe. Shinaka Kigwe. I'm the Rabbi Achoyi. Adigi Onye Dikagi. Bemucha Taridi Magi. Adamiri Juru Munanya. Yomasiro Niroyame. Meri Nabukemo. Amamama Siamasi Ezina. Abijere Na Jerusalem Kuoku. Yagabese Nakapanda. Jehovah Nidye Ebube. Akama Hotu Chidikagi. Akama Hotu Chidikagi. Akama Hotu Chidikagi. Akama Hotu Chidikagi. Akwagi Yiri Abangwa Abangwe. Akwagi Chiri Abangwa Abangwe. Akwagi Chiri Abangwa Abangwe. Akwagi Chiri Abangwa Abangwe. Oge Rola Bichabike. Oge Rola Bichabike. Oge Rola Bichagaba. Oge Rola Bichagaba. Oge Rola Bichabike. Oge Rola Bichabike. Oge Rola Bichabike. Oge Rola Bichabike. Akama Hutu Onye Dikagi. Akama Hutu Onye Dikagi. Akama Hutu Onye Dikagi. Akama Hutu Onye Dikagi. Jesus, you are worthy. Savior, thou art worthy. Thou alone art worthy to be praised. Thou alone art worthy to be praised. Thou alone art worthy to be praised. Thou alone. You carry me when others they carry their God. Now you defeat me, Lord, when others they feed their ghosts. Lift up your hands, I am about shatter. Jesus, you know they use me play. Jesus, you know they use me play. Lift your hands. Araba ribiti, aribi ramata. Oh God, there is no one like you. Araba ribiti. Aribi ramata. Oh God,
there is no one like you.
Something but I go. I've got something but I go. Something but I go. I've got something but if all I have is Jesus, I've got something. Lift up your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands and close your eyes. Somebody's about to feel the weight of God's encounter. It's about to come on your head. Lift up your hands. As many that hunger and thirst, something is about to hit you now. It's about to hit you now. Something is about to touch you now. There's going to be an awakening, a revival of your spirit, a revival of your soul, a revival of your body. Lift up your hand and close your eyes. I can never go the same way I came. Something must change around me. Something must change around my life. There must be a manifestation. There must be a testimony. Something must change. Something must transform. Lift your hand and close your eyes. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. You will shout Jesus on top of your voice. As you shout Jesus, you will shout Jesus on top of a voice. You will shout it 7 times. On the 7th one, there is an air that will come upon you. It is that same mighty rushing wind that came upon the apostles, and they were filled with the Holy Ghost. The Lord spoke to me. He said, I want to encounter 29 persons. He said, I want to encounter 29 persons. Lift up your hand and close your eyes. You will shout Jesus 7 times. That man, Jesus. That man that cannot fail. That man that cannot lie. That man that cannot disappoint. That man that has the key. The key. The key. The key to your door. The key to your manifestation. The key to your testimony. Lift up your hands and close your eyes. You will shout Jesus 7 times. And on the 7th one, a mighty rushing wind will come upon your head. A mighty rushing wind. It will come upon your family. Lift your hand and close your eyes. Number 1,
Jesus.
2.
Jesus.
Number 3.
Jesus.
Number 4.
Jesus.
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Number 5. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Number 6. Yada babasha. Breathe in now. Breathe in, then breathe out. Then breathe out. Watch what will happen now. That fibroid we go. That sickness we go. That tears we roll away. That chain we break. That altar we catch fire. That family shall be settled. Number 7. Yes, 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 help her. Help thou my helper, helper. The power of God at the count of 7. Wherever you are, I yes, help her. That's the power of God. Right now, I break the chain. I launch it on your encounter. I break the chain. I break the cocoon. In the name of Jesus, I declare now, let there be a restoration. Let there be a testimony. I change your family background. I change your destiny. I renew your life. I renew your glory. Shabarabadata. Shabadabarata. 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 Where is the God of my father? Joshua Talina. Ebra bra 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 bra. 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 Shakotoyata, 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 Parasosoloto, Ebrada Babasha, Eyata Pepelete, Ebranoso, Eyatolo, Eredeles, Ebratosco, Eyatarabata, Eyagadebarata, 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 speaking tongues, speaking tongues, speaking tongues, speaking tongues, speaking tongues, Shakoto. Eregeto, Iyanababasha, Iyanababasha, that man, that woman, Eratosa, Ebragesa, Eyakata, Eyaketosia, Eyagadagadasa, 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 Hey, you got to get this. Hey, you got to get this. Ah, shut up, brother. 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 You got to get this. You got to get this. You got to get this. Shadele barata, ekwe kwe 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 ta, ekwe kwe torotosh, e yata tasha, e rata tolotosa, brakatos ke pasha, iyagada brakada shata. Lift up your hands. Rababa
Take my sweat, rub on your face.
Yes.
Take my sweat again, rub on your face. Power of God. Power of God. Lift your hands, church.
Yes, sir.
This atmosphere is so conducive for marine powers. No matter the force that has been fighting you.
Yes, sir.
Under this atmosphere, something will change in your life.
Amen.
If you shout amen, heaven will answer your prayer now.
Amen.
If you shout amen, heaven will respond to you now.
Amen.
Let me hear that your amen. Let it come like a thunder.
Amen.
Take my sweat again, rub on your face for the third time. Obesia na huyim ya otito di raya oburuwo usobu mola tonu ya ndini le babara ni me Jehovah hadi kukuza yona di ewezuga anono dunga rombe bi ebi uguza ya uguza ya notu akati ova barani yo gige otu asiri masi Jehovah. O to a city message, Jehovah. Imamaya, 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 dear Bube. Imamaya, 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 dear Bube. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I see a challenge God said I should handle for you. You have a visa to travel. You have a visa to travel. But I'm seeing something that'll make you not to travel again. Do like this. I saw where your destiny helper died 2 days before you traveled. Your destiny helper died 2 days before you traveled. So the travel did not take place again. Somebody is very sick now. Eh?
Yes.
Very sick.
Yes.
Very, very sick. When you reach where the person is later today, this same hand you have used to touch my face and touch your face, don't shake anybody. When you see the person, let it be the first person you will touch. As you touch the person, the grace upon my life and the one upon the life of our father, with that sickness is an attack. It's not an ordinary sickness. Anytime somebody wants to help you and it is 99% close to you getting what you want, story will enter. This is not the first person. This is not the second person. So if nothing is done now, the only person that can help you to reach your destiny in life, I saw where the person, just like that, what is the problem? They say, just malaria.
Just the person just died. But this is actually a force that killed the person. So the Lord said, don't shake anybody when you get home. Take the hand. Or when you reach where the person is, you stay. Touch the person's hand. Say, in the name of Jesus, I command the sickness. 24 hours. Take your leave. The moment you do it, you will come back on Sunday and have a testimony. Talk! In the name of Jesus, shout the amen 3 times. Number one.
Amen.
Number two.
Amen.
Number three.
Amen.
You there? Come. You want the destiny changer? Lift your hands. Is my time up? The sister did not say yes. She was still singing destiny changer. She said the time must not be up during my time.
It mustn't be off.
Yes. Come and change my destiny today. They say, come and change my destiny today. You are the miracle worker. You are the miracle worker. Come and do a miracle today. Come and do a miracle today. Your name is Yahweh, your name is Yah. Somebody say you are a miracle worker. Yeah, your name is Yah. Somebody say your name is
Yah.
Your name is Yah. Your name is Yah. Yahweh, your name is Yah. You are a miracle. Walking God, your name is Yah. You are my destiny changer. I know you can change my destiny. Oh, come and change my destiny today.
Come and change my destiny today.
You are the great and mighty God who so greatly to be praised. Beautiful in all situations. You are the joy of the whole. Say, you are the great and mighty God who so greatly to be praised. Beautiful in all situations.
Hallelujah. Let
me pray for you. Kneel down. The moment I saw you now, something spoke to me to talk to you. Put your hand. There's a challenge now. You have a challenge. It's a financial challenge. Right now, in your shop. In your shop. You need money badly now. You have prayed and prayed faster and faster. No way. Nobody have dashed you money for a long time. Favor does not come. Right now, I'm seeing an issue that if I don't pray, it will make you not to sew clothes for others. Because I'm seeing here you have collected materials, you have collected jobs, but the money they give you used it to solve a problem. So you don't have money now to sew for the people. You're a church worker here? I want to dash you money. Bring my bag for me. Onise Iyanu.
You're the God of awesome wonders, a tested of your power. Onise,
Onise Iyanu. You are, you have shown me so much mercy.
Someone mercy, much more than I deserve.
My eyes,
oh, my ears have heard the wonders of
your name.
Can I hear you say, creation?
Change your dancing step.
Amen.
You didn't say amen.
Amen.
Say it well.
Amen.
Two things. I saw the best wedding in town.
Amen.
And I saw an official car.
Amen.
And I saw a well-paid job.
Amen.
There's an angel by your side now. The angel carried perfume in her hand. And he was saying, it is for Yewade, Yewade, Yewande.
Yes, 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 yes.
Yewade, I'm hearing that name, Yewande, Yewande. You're not clapping your hand for Jesus. You are not celebrating Jesus. Lift your hands wherever you are. I prophesy to you. As I hear your amen, I restore the glory of your Father's house.
Amen.
I restore the glory of your Father's house.
Amen.
Pay attention.